Welcome to an example of how to find a z-score for a standard normal distribution on the newer version of the t84, given we know that the probability of the z-score being greater than c equals 0.6127. This probability represents an area under the graph of the standard normal distribution shown here, and because we have the probability of z being greater than c, this should be the area to the right of some value of c or some z-score. And because we know when z equals 0, the area to the right would be 0.5, we should recognize the value of c of the z-score is going to be negative. It's going to be between 0 and negative 1. So let's just say that c is somewhere in here, where again, because we know the probability of z being greater than c is equal to 0.6127, 0.6127 is the area to the right, which should be the area of this shaded region here. So this area is 0.6127. However, in order to find this value of c using the t84, we need the area to the left of c and not to the right. And since the total area under the standard normal distribution is equal to 1, we can find the area to the left by taking 1 and subtracting the area on the right. 1 minus 0.6127 equals 0.3873, which again would be this area here. Another way to think of this is if we know that the probability of z being greater than c equals 0.6127, this also tells us the probability of z being less than c is equal to 1 minus 0.6127, which equals 0.3873. And now we can find the value of c we're looking for by using the inverse norm function on the t84 graphing calculator. To do this, we'll first select the inverse norm function, then we'll enter the probability or area to the left, followed by mu, the mean, and then sigma, the standard deviation. And this returns the x value with the given probability, the probability of x being less than c. But in our case, we're looking for a z-score, not an x value. So if we let mu equal 0 and sigma equal 1, the x value will be the z-score with the given probability of z being less than c. So because the area must be on the left, we'll be using this area here to find the z-score, or this value of c, which again will satisfy the probability that z being greater than c equals 0.6127. So from the home screen, we press second vars for the distribution menu. We want to select option 3, inverse norm. So this is the screen that's new on the newer version of the 84. We wouldn't see this screen on the older 84 or the 83. So it's first asking for the area or the probability, which must be to the left of the value of c, or the z-score we're looking for. So in this case, we'd enter 0.3873. Enter. Because we're looking for a z-score, we do want mu to be 0 and sigma to be 1, which are the default values for mu and sigma. So we'll press enter down to paste. Once the cursor is on paste, we press enter, which pastes or copies the information to the home screen. If we arrow to the left, notice how we have inverse norm followed by the area or probability to the left. Then we have mu and sigma. On the older 84 and 83, we enter this information from the home screen. So now we press enter, and notice how the z-score is between 0 and negative 1, which we expected. Rounded to 4 decimal places, we would say c is approximately negative 0.2864. So we know c is approximately negative 0.2864, which means the probability that the z-score is greater than negative 0.2864, because this is a rounded value of c, this would be approximately the given probability of 0.6127. I hope you found this helpful.